Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what's new in ProPresenter 7.16? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've wanted to do any of the things that you may have heard that Pro 7.16 can do, go ahead, like, subscribe, ring the bell icon, you know, all that stuff. Well, leave a comment as well. So, Renewed Vision has done it again. I never cease to be amazed at how many improvements they released to ProPresenter 7. And now we're on the 16th one since ProPresenter 7 was released in January of 2020, I believe. So, a lot of cool features have been added and some that are just really useful. So let's head over to the computer and I'll show you exactly what I mean with this. So here we are in Pro 7.16, and the very first thing that I want you to consider is, what if you get an image from someone and they've got an iPhone, and as a result they took the photo in HEIC format. That's the high efficiency image codec format. Not JPEG, not PNG, not GIF or GIF, depending on who you talk to. None of those. HEIC. Well, in ProPresenter 7.15 and earlier, you just were out of luck unless you went through the extra trouble of converting it into a JPEG or etc. Right? So, it wasn't hard to do on a Mac, but you might need additional software on a Windows machine. So let me show you something that they've added. So if we click down here and go to From Finder on the Mac, it's probably Windows Explorer on Windows. Click that. Then you'll see that it allows me to bring in any of these HEIC files that I want to do. So not only do I have to, can I bring in JPEGs of either flavor, JPG or JPEG? Had some problems with that the other day, not in ProPresenter, in another piece of software. PNGs, etc. HEICs are available. So I've already brought one in, and so I thought that I would show it to you along with the second thing that they've done all at one time. So here's an HEIC that I brought in. You might recognize this guy. And you might notice something else about this. This is a vertical image, but for whatever reason, I've got this blurriness around the outside. Well, how did I do that? Is that a big, long tutorial that I can show you how to do? Well, let me show you. It's actually pretty simple. You right-click here, and you select Scale and Blur. So, Scale to Fit is kind of the default, and there we go. Just has the black bars on the other underside. The problem with that, of course, is these black bars are only if there is nothing underneath that. And if I select this live video source, then it's going to bleed through. So you can maybe see. Hi. My webcam showing through right there, and so that's no good. So what I need to do is go back to playlist and right click on it and go down to scale and blur. And when I click on that, it just basically blows it up, blurs it, and adds a nice little, this is just a little subtleness here, little drop shadow and outline around it to kind of pull it away from the background a little bit. So it gives you kind of a subtle 3D effect. We don't have any controls over this, so you can't change the amount of blur, you can't change the framing of it or anything like that, but that is That's actually the first two things. And by the way, this works for videos as well as images. So HEIC format and scale and blur. First two things. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to tdm.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to tdm.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. Now, a lot of people are going to be really excited about those. But the next one, I've just seen, in fact, yesterday on the official ProPresenter users community that I run along with Renewed Vision on Facebook, I posted and I said, which of the features in 7.16 makes you most excited, and this is the one. So I'm going to have to hide myself real quick to show it to you, and I kind of on purpose hid it earlier by selecting this, but if I go over here to macros, you'll notice that they look a little bit different. Before, they just had this icon here, that or that, and you could change the color of the icon itself. There was no background. So that has changed, and that's a very helpful thing. So if you look up here in the upper left-hand corner, this is some of the macros that I have going on just based on where I am. I open these tutorials with these different slides that do different things. So that's an important piece of the puzzle, is you can now just glance and see that you can either have just the M for macro, and as you mouse on that, that shows it what it's doing and change the color of the background, or back here. So one thing I might show you sometime later is I've got an on-air light. My youngest daughter tends to burst into the room while I'm recording. So I got an on-air light that isn't web-enabled or anything like that, but I plugged it into a smart outlet that is. So I'm using this, and to basically delineate these out, I have created these macros that turn it on and turn it off, and I right-clicked on it and I selected change icon. And when I did that, I selected this light icon so that I knew that this is the light turning on icon, and then this black one I selected and it turns it off. And you can't hear that it just caused a little click on a little relay, but that's exactly what it did. So I can have that set up. So it has those default little choices, but if I right click here and select change icon, I can actually import any icon that I want. So, you know, I could do the 26 letters of the alphabet, I could do a power on icon, a play icon, any of those. But if I click import icon, it enables me to import basically any image that I want. So a little something I've been working on right there, where someone was running ProPresenter 7 and didn't know what they were doing, so I could import that, in fact. So let me do that. And I've done that, and now that's there. So I don't have to do some sort of special format or anything like that. Just a JPEG will suffice. So I could have a picture of my on-air light right here, maybe even with it lit up in one case and dark in another case. And, you know, if I put this on a slide as it is, that's kind of hard to see. So you would want to keep it pretty simple, because it is itty bitty teeny tiny unless you zoom this in all the way. And then it's still not going to be huge. So where is that one? Yeah, right there. So you're probably not going to want to use most photos, but you do have that as an option. One other thing, well, a couple other things. First off, lower right-hand corner, you see this? We can now organize macros like this as just little buttons. It actually kind of, shout out to Amanda Congold over at Renewed Vision for saying this, it kind of looks like a Stream Deck with these icons here. So you could just have these on here, and, you know, maybe you have a Stream Deck page that has these same ones in order. But wouldn't it be nice if you could further collect them together into, like, folders or whatever? Well, you can. So we've got the default collection here, and now I'm going to add a new collection, and let's just call this Lights. Okay, and now I can add a macro and just put that in Lights, or if I delete that macro out and go back to my default collection, I can also either add it to my Lights collection or move it to my Lights collection. So adding it to my Lights collection means that it's in both places. So let's do that. Now I can go down here to the Lights collection, and it's both here, and back in the default collection, it's right here. Or let's say I wanted to move this, so I'm going to right click, move to Lights, and that deletes it from this default collection, and over here in the Lights collection, I have it here. So just realized how creepy it is to have myself staring. Okay, so let me go ahead, and I'm going to make that go away and make that go away. Okay, anyway, so I can do either of those, just whatever makes sense. Some different collections you might want to have is, you might want to have a collection. You might want to have a collection for any macros that control lights. You might want to have collections for stage screen actions. You might want to have collections for clear actions. You might want to have collections for the type of service. You know, maybe you use these macros on a Sunday morning service and these in a youth service. Those might be some different collections that you might want to have. And if you've ever seen my tutorial on how to use props to make a game, you might want to have a collection of those props making just that game. And, you know, if you have several rounds, maybe you'd have like Family Feud round one, Family Feud round two, etc. And so you've got a lot of flexibility there. So that is kind of some of the fun stuff that you can do with collections in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/ Pro, the number 7, and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.